Ah, frack. Wrong background.
Ah, I fixed it. Oh, I almost fixed it. Okay, it is the weekend, so more bad news coming in from Bad News Bravo. People are waiting still for their unemployment benefits as eviction looms. I got some stories to share with you, and I have some solutions. And my solution isn't Washington, who just went on vacation. They're like, oh, okay, we all see that you need some money. You're all struggling here, and the top 1% just keeps to eat everything for breakfast, lunch, dinner, wiping everyone out. Here's my solution. I'll just give it to you right now. If you want to stimulate the economy, you want to know what you do? Give this stuff right here. Give this the $2 bills and whatever you got. Give this stuff. Fake paper. Don't give this stuff, though. They won't know what to do with it. To the people, just give it to them. They're going to spend it right away. The poor spend money. Well, actually, they spend debt. That's what it is. This stuff right here, kids, it's just debt. This is not money. This is money. Just give it all to they'll spend it right away. Stimulate immediately. You want to screw things up? Well, actually, it's not. You're not screwing things up because it was designed this way. Is give money to the corporations. And look at me. I'm just like giving it all away. No, Johnny Bravo, stick to your script. But the S&P 500 hit all-time highs. Oh, shocker, right? Oh, so how does this debt-based system work? And how are you able to get rid of everyone and transfer wealth into the rich? Oh, I think I know. And corporate borrowing. This stuff, the bonds. Ah, you see, they can just print it. They print it. They get this stuff. The rich just buy back their stocks, leaving the 50%. They go bye-bye, so we're going to take a look at that. And Keynesian scholars, because we are in a Keynesian debt-based system that no one understands, says that we should not worry about debt. He actually says it's mad to worry about debt. I'll show you mad. Hold on. Wait for it.
You left the toilet seat up.
Welcome back to my channel, where I leave the toilet seat up. I don't always put toothpaste on the, I don't put it back. I just, you know, I'm just not getting it, right? Men, I don't know. But if you like business news, stock market news, stuff that they just didn't teach you about in school, which I do because I'm a high school business teacher, and I'm just shocking everyone. But if you like this kind of stuff, would you at least just think about it? Little subscribe button. I don't know. Is it just me? I don't want to grab that toilet seat. I don't. So you have two solutions. One, you know what? Okay, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to go on Amazon when I'm done with this. I'm going to find a toilet seat that I can go my hand over and it goes up and down. Otherwise, you have two options. I can either A, pee on the toilet seat, or I leave it open and you just fall in. But coming in from CNBC, right there. I like to circle it. I like drawing on things. I'm a drawer. She thought unemployment benefits were coming. 2 months later, eviction looms. Really, the government's not helping you out. I always thought the government is here to help. I guess not. Scrolling down on this article, Jennifer Moon, 46, has waited more than 2 months for unemployment benefits in Georgia. And then what do our politicians do? They're like, it's time to take a break, go on vacation, hit the Hamptons. Without income, Moon missed 2 months of rent. Her landlord threatened eviction at month's end. Thousands of Americans have waited months. I've been hearing that in the comments section. And here is what is, here's a lie right here. Jobless rate compared to the Great Depression levels. Oh, right. You're telling me we went from 14% to 10%. Yeah, I'm not buying it. It just all depends on how you want to calculate the numbers. I should probably go Casper on you because my hair is blocking all of the percentages. They didn't even count right now. They don't count government workers. Back in the day, back here in the 1930s, 1940s, like all this. No, if you work for the government, you were basically considered unemployed. And because you asked, I will show you. Here's how much each state workforce is employed by the government. Here you go. Where are you guys at? I'm over here in California. We're all burning down. Look at Hawaii, 20%. And Arkansas. Well, why are they putting Arkansas down here? I just will never understand that. Go ahead, roast me in the comments section. This is dad humor. Everything's sarcasm. Looking at what's going on. We got Maine. It's just everyone, right? A lot of people for the government, working for the government. And here's another indicator I like to use. You know, how many people are really working, right? Well, back in the day when it was good, we were up here. This is how many people were employed, all the way up here. And now we're all the way down here, okay? So how many people are actually employed? And breaking news, if you work for Uber for a minute, unless you're in California where they shut it down and Lyft, and man, this whole system, I'm not buying it. If you work a day, you're considered employed. That's it. You run one trip, you're like, you are fully employed. And if you have two jobs, which most people do now, because they can't keep up with this system of debt and they can't figure it out. They're like, wait, this is money. You're like, no, it's not money. Bonds, all that kind of garbage is that when you get two jobs, right? They count you as like two full employed people. Gotta have that double employment, but just government cooking the books like they have since 1929. It's just getting a lot worse or better than expected. And what's sad is Moon is a certified nursing assistant. This girl's struggling. Give her some cash, man. Give her, I probably zoomed in too much. So Jennifer, if you are seeing this, I would just like to apologize for my zooming. And oh man, this breaks my heart. Look at this. Moon, single woman. Doesn't have a family to fall back on, cares for her 30-year-old son with disability. I don't even have 5 cents to my name, Moon said last week. I am so frustrated, and I am so frustrated for you. I am so sorry, but I am only one guy with one magic wand of double stoof. I can only do so much. Coming in from CBS News, economy is slumping again. We're gonna call that a W, right? They say it's a V shape. It's more like, yeah, there we go again. Because you give people the money, they spend it, and we're like, oh, well, that's the economy, right? We're actually not really doing anything. We don't manufacture too much, do we? No, I think we lost that a long time ago. And Washington put stimulus on hold. You evilers. And I'm sorry, I do not follow politics too much. I kind of hit a couple things because I know how it works. And the more time I spend on the noise, the more I get frustrated. But I'm assuming what I heard was Donald Trump, and I can come down. He tried to give people some cash, right? And here we go with the politics. Wasn't working. And I can't stand like listening to these people. Coming on down. Let's see. I like to go down to the bottom and see what the truth is. Even if income does drop in August, okay. We have airlines. They're all going out of business. And then coming down here, let's see. And here it is. Made it down to the very bottom. B of A Harris, on the other hand, predicts Mr. Trump. I thought he was our president. Executive order will do little to stop the slump. Well, take something, man. Delaying payroll tax could boost the average. I'll take it by $128 per pay period for the rest of the year. Give it to them. Cut their taxes. Delete taxes. Like, help people. And I know I don't talk Trump. No politics. It's too dividing. Everyone like freaks out. It's like a bad religion cult. And hey, you Q supporters got a little shout out from the president. Woo! Looky there. Again, I like to stay kind of balanced, okay? Call me crazy. I look at your side. I come up with my own side. I figured out I change, not like some dudes out there that still wear Crocs watching my channel, but no, it's okay. You're a subscriber if you wear Crocs, no hate. They just weren't comfortable for me. Maybe just me. The S&P 500's return to a record doesn't tell the full story with 60% of stocks with losses. Do you see? It's a specific sector. And hey, how about if I help because I don't want to be a channel that's like, oh, all bad news and Trump and Biden and all this. Well, what's a solution, right? When I argue with my wife, it's like, well, can we find a solution, or you just want to argue for a little bit? Because if you just want to argue, I'm down. Let's do this. Just let me know. Solution or argue? Okay, argue. All right, let's do this for 5 minutes. But let me show you a solution. Because the truth is, yes, a handful of stocks are doing really well. They seem to be lockstep in when it comes to government and control and privacy. Oh, Facebook's really private, right? All right, so what are we looking at? The S&P, that's what they talked about, the S&P 500. Let's just say we wanted to trade the S&P 500, which would be lots of different symbols, ETFs, you can trade SPY, but let's just look at SPX for argument's sake. And rather than buy and holding, which I have, yes, I probably 30 years I've held the S&P 500, have not touched it. So call me the kettle black or whatever. I just can't. I can't move the thing. It's just there. But if you were to trade it to make money, I like that. Oh, I said make money. Then my brain says, I have to say, not financial advice, too much risk. Don't listen to anything I say. You will lose all of your money if you listen to my stupid trading strategies. But look at this. Oh, should I go? Nah, I'm okay being in the picture, right? I even have indicators. Buy. Do we sell on the day? No. Let's even go back. You know, let's go back to when all things went to the pooper and see how close or how much money I would have lost you on that. All right. So we would have had a sell right here. We would have had a buy. Okay. So that's good, right? You buy, sell. You made money there. You buy there. Oh, you sell there. Huh. Go figure. Because we're under the nine. Eh? And then it goes, do we have any buy signals? No, no, no. Oh, there we go. Buy signal. Buy there, sell there. Made money. Buy there, sell there, buy there. All these. Look, every single one of them. Even when it dumped in the toilet, still profitable. And if you like this, if this is making sense, you're like, oh my gosh, this is kind of cool. I do have a course on it. It's $1,000. But while I'm filming, because I'm filming right now, you can get it for $800 off, so $200. So come on to the family. Let's hang out. Let's tell our friends to stop doing the other thing that we've been doing for so long that just really hasn't worked. Like, oh, when you want to buy? Well, you need to have a reason why you enter a position and exit, not just random. And I'll help you with that. But if for some reason it says 1,000, that means the code is gone. There will be more tomorrow. I film every day. Looking at this, see this line? We elevated factors. That's a good thing. We want to go up. We want to trade winners, not losers. This is a winner. I can click around and I can find you lots of losers that happen to be within that 80%, but we don't trade losers. We just trade winners. And if you want to start off with two free stocks, link in the description on that one too, Webull. The friends over at Webull, man, love that platform. They give you two free stocks. I like that. They give me one. So they kind of ripped me off a little bit, but you get two, so you win. And just to back up what I was saying from Financial Times, which is an image, I could not highlight it. I can move the image, I just can't highlight it. Can I highlight this guy? There we go. K-shaped recovery. I like that, right? Where are we going? We're going all over. Stock recovery widens gap between winners and losers, and expert insights. And I just said that, right? That you got to pick winners, don't pick losers, and understand the system that is in place right now. Biggest transfer of wealth hidden under the auspice. Is that a word? I probably shouldn't even have used it. I would like to continue with the story, but I really don't want to pay $40 a month, but you just come to me and I'll tell you what the story is going to be. I already do Bloomberg. I don't, too many subscriptions. I think Bloomberg hit with $300-$500 a year. That's what it is to get this stuff. Dang it. And print. You guys still do print? Stuff shows up, you know? Fingers get all black. And coming in from Market Watch, bam. Like that pink? I got another one for you right there. Bam. Corporate borrowing in 2020. That'd be right now to smash prior records. Goldman says, really? I would have never thought that. So you're saying that Apple and Facebook and Netflix and all those corporations, they can print money and the Fed will backstop them just in case. We got your back. We'll just buy those bonds, right? That's what they do. They create. There is no such thing as money except for this. You know, gold, maybe Bitcoin. That still out on that one. Don't smash that dislike, please. Just all we do is hit the like. My button is not working. Now I'm upset. Let me click it. Let's see if it works. If I can make you laugh one time, that's all that I ask on this channel. It's just think about that one too. Dang, your finger's right on it. Really helps out the YouTube thing. But guys, look, forecast. High grade. Yeah, that's what it needs to be though. No junk. No, that comes later. High grade supply could top almost 2 trillion. $350 billion of junk-rated bonds. Okay, moving into the junk. But all it is, the entire system, and I'll just tell you how it is rather than... I try to make it simple, right? High school business, you just break me down the story, right? They create the... Where'd my bond sheet go? I don't know. I got to buy a bond. Someone... Here. Someone needs to buy me a bond. Send me a bond. This is a is this bond? Monopoly? Okay, same thing. On a sheet of paper, they just write bond. That's it. Good job, Apple. And then someone's like, yeah, I'll buy it. Everyone buys it. Same thing. That's where money comes from. Well, not really. It's just debt. It's all debt. The whole system's just debt. Government writes a bond, and the Treasury then can print. But then the Fed goes, ooh, I'll buy that bond. And then that's where you get this stuff. And then you got to pay this stuff back with your taxes every time. They shoot out one of these currency things. You got to pay it back with taxes. All of it. All the banks making their cheddar. All of the corporations. They can't fail. Same thing in 08. Too big to fail. The banks were too big to fail. The companies are too big to fail. But the people are failing. And I can tell you when there is, because they always talk about the reset. I see some of you YouTubers talking about a reset. I don't know what that's going to look like. But I can tell you, it's not going to look good for you. It just won't. Because you're not in control. They're in control. But Johnny Bravo, give us who's the companies. What's going on with this story? All right, B of A. All right, they're doing it. Johnson & Johnson, right? They have AAA credit rating. Johnson & Johnson. They're going to borrow, right? $7.5 billion. And then we give the CEO the cash. And then they buy back their stocks and make more money. It just goes down the list. As long, they want the rating, but we all know from 08, you know, ratings, what does that mean? Look at those bars. We're winning, breaking more records. A gray area is recessions. I got lucky on that one. When last year, I'm like, 2020 will be a recession. I'm like, is it going to happen? Yeah, sometimes. Sometimes I get lucky. And I'm trying to think, what are some things that I got right and things that I got wrong? 08, housing market. Got that one right. Right now, housing market. I got it wrong. I would have never thought that, hey, greatest recession, depression of all times, housing market is booming. So slap my hand on that one. And I have been saying, wait, I don't know. This is unprecedented. I don't get it. I was right on Bitcoin getting out at 8,300, getting back in on the way. I don't know what's going to happen in the future. And please do not use my trading system to trade Bitcoin. It is way too volatile. That is like you have candles and then you have wicks. It's like, woo, one buy down here, one, you know, like it's not good. They liquidate all the idiots. And again, the people that own the system make the money. Oh, and I really like gold. I've been good on gold. I think I called that one. That's good. Could be wrong. I could turn the dollar. I'm waiting. That's a waiting. We'll see. With the decelerating, right? It's not looking good. I don't like trading losers. So I have to wait for a breakout and then I will trade UUP because you cannot trade the Dixie Chicks, DXY. And coming in from Bloomberg, which I pay for. I think Bloomberg, okay, you're worth it. I'll give it to you, buddy. Economics, since I am an economics kind of a guy, it's mad to worry about mounting debt now, Keynesian scholar says. Keynes, sorry. Now let's just do a little clip of the video, and then let me go Casper on you for a brief second so you can... I have a tie just like that. That's pretty cool.
I don't think in your three volume on Keynes there was the magnitude of fiscal debt and deficit that we have now. What do we do about the magnitude of the debt?
Well, there was really, if you think of the debt incurred in the First World War, I mean, that was absolutely huge, 200 or 250% of gross domestic product. So that was sort of comparable to what we're seeing today. And the way they got out of it was through the growth of the economy eventually. It's the only way really to reduce the net burden of debt is the economy has to grow. Right.
And this just in, breaking news. Sorry, I did not turn Mickey. Oh, there he goes. He's gone. Our economy. What do we even have? What do we? Growth of our economy. No, we have a growing stock market. We do not have a growing economy. And that's just the way it is. So he wants us to grow our economy to get out of this debt, even though it's a debt-based system. I don't see it happening. And they're like, you think this is just going to solve it? Just give the people this. This doesn't do it. You need to stop, because that's all we are, right? We're just darn consumers. We just consume. But hey, if I could, I would like you, if you could, pass the favor on, and I'll see you tomorrow.